It's been 2 months since I replaced my CalDigit Element Hub with CalDigit's newer TS4 dock. And wow, I didn't expect how different those two would turn out to be. So in this video, I'm going to review the TS4 and try to answer the question, is it really worth that additional money? We'll start with the unboxing and physical properties of the CalDigit TS4 dock, then we will move to some usability and speed tests. I will share with you how I configured my dock to best suit my workflow as a software engineer and a content creator, and finally we're going to break down who this dock is really for, who should avoid it, and who should opt in for the cheaper and simpler CalDigit Element Hub. Hello coders, my name is Caro and I'm a software engineer and a huge tech enthusiast, and in this new series I'm going to bring you tech reviews of all the products and gadgets that have the potential to streamline and simplify your workflow, saving you precious time and making your job that much more enjoyable. Talking about saving your time, let's get straight into it. The latest MacBooks featuring more ports and even a built-in SD card reader, you could really start questioning if the TS series from CalDigit is not by any chance an overkill for present days. Ethernet port, display port, separate mic and audio jack, do we really need all of that? Well, it depends. But the number and type of ports is not the only thing that differentiates the TS4 dock from other Thunderbolt 4 docks like the Razer dock or the cheaper CalDigit Element Hub. We'll get into those differences, but let's first start with unboxing our dock. Similarly to other CalDigit products, you can see the highlights of what TS4 offers just on the front of the box. TS4 has 18 ports, and that includes the one that you use to connect it to your main host device like your laptop or an iPad, so technically you have 17 free ports to use for whatever you want. The dock can charge your host device and it delivers 98 watts of power, which is more than enough for the 13 and 14 inch versions of MacBook Pro, but not quite for the 16 inch one, which by default comes with a 140 watts charger. The next feature is the monitor compatibility. TS4 can support two 4K monitors at 60Hz or a single 8K monitor, which seems to be a standard for the Thunderbolt 4 docks now. Something that I was really looking forward to as a video creator is the SD card reader for both regular and micro SD cards. TS4 also comes with a certified cable, whatever that means. We'll talk about the cable later in the video, and a 2.5 gigabit Ethernet port. On the back of the box, you can find basically the same information as on the front, just written in a list format and translated into multiple languages, plus additional info about the dimensions of the dock, which are 42 by 141 by 113 millimeters. Keep in mind that the power supply for the dock is external, and as we will shortly see, it's not a small brick. On one side of the box, there is a detailed description of what the infographics on the front are saying, as well as a list of what those 18 ports actually are, with specified speeds of each of the different USB ports. The other side just reiterates the same information, displayed on top of a high-resolution photo of the dock's back and front. I'll run you through the full list once we take the dock out of the box. I will now let you rest from my voice, and please enjoy a little bit of that unboxing ASMR. There are 5 main elements to this unit: the TS4 dock, power supply, 1 meter power cable, 80 centimeter Thunderbolt 4 cable, and rubber feet that you can install on either side of the dock if you decide not to use it in the vertical position. First thing you notice about this dock, and which is consistent across most of the Thunderbolt station products, is this ripped texture, which I believe should kind of help with heat distribution or just not heating the surface it's placed on too much. We already got the dimensions of the unit from the box, and now the weight is 640 grams. On the front, wait, let me fix this one for those of you who are not in Australia. Yes, that's better. So on the front you can see the CalDigit branding LED that will light up when you are connected to a host device, a combo audio jack, and SD and micro SD UHS-II card readers. A USB-A port that can also passively charge the connected device, meaning you don't need the host device like your laptop to be connected for this port to work as a charger. There are also 2 USB-C ports, one delivering 20 watts of power and both being able to passively charge connected devices. Just to get it out of the way, any USB port on this device, back or front, will be a USB 3.2 Gen 2 port delivering 7.5 watts of power and data transfers at 10 gigabits per second. Any Thunderbolt 4 port will supply 15 watts of power and speeds up to 40 gigabits per second. The intended bottom side of the dock has a nice rubbery texture in a color just slightly lighter than the dark silver casing. And now to the real deal, the back of the dock. Starting from the left, you have a Kensington lock to secure your device from being stolen. Then a full-size 2.5 gigabit Ethernet port, which is generally the speed you will find on most high-end modern routers. Then a power input, 4 USB-A ports, two of which can deliver passive charging. Underneath that, 3 Thunderbolt 4 ports, one of which is dedicated to be used as a connection to your host device, here marked as computer. Those are generally the ports you'd want to use for your Thunderbolt monitor or Thunderbolt hard drive or any other Thunderbolt 4 device you would like to daisy chain to your machine. Just above that, there is a microphone and audio jack. I keep my speakers connected to that port, even though they are Bluetooth speakers. I find them to be able to play louder and cleaner when used via a wired connection. Plus, it makes it easier to just reconnect one cable when switching between my personal and work laptop, and not having to worry about switching Bluetooth, as my speakers don't reconnect automatically. On the top, you have more of that ripped texture and nothing else. Now, let me show you how to install the rubber feet, in case you want to put your device in a horizontal position, which is how I like to use it, tucked under my monitor. You don't really have to do this, but I find it helps the dock to not slide and scratch the desk when I connect stuff to the front of it, and it lifts it above the surface of the desk just a little bit, which should help with that heat distribution. So the trick is to insert the far ends of each of those rubber feet first, pressing it firmly just as the rib meets the frame. Then you can gently press the rest of it into feet. If you start from one end and follow through the middle first, I can almost guarantee you'll stretch it too much and won't be able to tuck the other end before it meets the frame. With the main unit checked out, let's see what else we have. Power cable is not much to talk about. Australian plug here, but you'll get whatever version is supplied in your country. As I mentioned before, the Thunderbolt 4 cable measures 80 centimeters. If that's not enough, CalDigit offers this cable in a 2-meter version, but it is quite XP. I think it's also worth mentioning that this dock and this cable will work with any USB-C and Thunderbolt 3 devices. However, if you don't have and are not planning on getting a Thunderbolt 4 computer, there are definitely cheaper alternatives that you should consider first. The power brick is an interesting one. It's actually the same size as the CalDigit Element Hub's power supply. It has matte black finish, measures 20 by 74 by 150 millimeters, and weighs 310 grams. My favorite part and upgrade over the Element Hub is this 90 degrees angle for the output cable. Side by side, the power brick doesn't seem that big compared to the dock itself, but it's worth keeping in mind that you'll need to make space for it either on or below your desk. Mine lives in an aluminum cable channel that was an optional extension to my seat stand desk. Talking about my desk, let me show you how I set up my CalDigit TS4 for maximum comfort and productivity. There are a couple of things that are extremely important for me, and they are all related to what I use my workstation for, and that is creating software and videos, managing people and projects, and karaoke. Okay, so first, I swap between two different laptops. One is my work MacBook Pro 15-inch and one is my personal 13-inch one. I also tested the dock on a Windows machine and it worked just fine, with the small difference that it needed to have the CalDigit drivers installed manually. In terms of the essential peripherals I need connected to my laptop, those are my ultrawide 38-inch LG Thunderbolt monitor, keyboard, trackpad and a mouse. I prefer using trackpad for everything, but then mouse for like Blender and other 3D stuff, cam links so that I can use my mirrorless camera as a webcam when I have Zoom meetings, my USB microphone for recording videos and for meetings, speakers for that karaoke. No, but for real, the right music really helps me with motivation and staying in the flow when I code and create. Some things that are not always connected, but I really enjoy having the ports on the front of the TS4 to connect to, are my SSD, SD card for when I import photos and videos from my camera, and a simple USB-C cable for when I develop mobile apps and want to debug on a real device. As you can see, the CalDigit TS4 works perfectly for those requirements. All the permanently connected cables are neatly hidden in the back. All the ports I need variable access to are on the front. The dock doesn't slide when I push the USB cable or an SD card in because of those nice rubber feet that I installed before. And the dock just fits nicely underneath my floating monitor in the horizontal position with the laptop sitting just next to it. The ergonomics of this unit, the passive charging ports, and just the sheer range of different ports is what, in my opinion, differentiates the TS4 from most of the competition. Now the speed test. I wanna keep this section short as I explained how I ran those speed tests in my previous video, so if you wanna check that out, I'll drop a link to it in the description below. That's also where I established the baseline for comparison between different docks. As you can see, both USB-C and USB-A ports deliver an approximate reading speed of 440 megabytes per second and writing of 410 megabytes per second. That's around 10 to 20 megabytes per second faster than the Element Hub and around 30 to 50 megabytes faster than the direct connection. We are going to talk about what makes Thunderbolt 4 so great in just a second, but if you already feel like the CalDigit TS4 might be just the dock you were looking for, check the description below as Try and Buy, the store I purchased my TS4 from, was kind enough to offer a free cable organizer to the first 10 people who use the code TS4CaroCodes at checkout. Let's talk about Thunderbolt 4 specifically now. As I mentioned in my previous video, my favorite is that you can connect up to two 4K monitors or a single 8K monitor, which isn't available with any other connection type like USB 4 or Thunderbolt 3 that support a maximum of a single 4K monitor. It means that two monitors connected to your dock are able to receive the data from your laptop that travels through just a single Thunderbolt 4 cable. Thunderbolt 4 offers the same maximum speed for data transfer as Thunderbolt 3 and USB 4, however, the minimum speed is at least twice as high, making your connection and data transfers faster on average. Finally, you can daisy chain your Thunderbolt 4 devices with minimal or non-loss of speed. This gives you unlimited possibilities of how you want to use your workspace or creative space. Now, who is CalDigit TS4 really for, and are you able to maybe save some money by opting in for the simpler and much cheaper CalDigit Element Hub? The short answer is included in this video where I compare both of them side by side and make my recommendation for you.